The Airbus A340 is largely a story of bad timing. Designed and built to compete against the Boeing 747, this four-engined single-deck aircraft was just a decade or so too late due to advancements in engine power and reliability, allowing for two-engined jets. Evolving regulations known as ETOPS allowed twin-engine aircraft to fly routes once exclusive to quad jets. Despite Airbus joining the quote, very large aircraft market a little too late, it managed to secure orders for a few hundred A340s. With deliveries beginning in 1993 and ending in 2012, this year marks 10 years since the last pair of A340s were sold off and delivered to a customer. Even with so much time having passed and much more efficient jets coming to market, there are nearly 80 Airbus A340s still listed as active at the time of making this video. So today, let's examine the largest operators of the type at the moment and where you're most likely to find the Airbus A340. According to Planespotters.net, there are 79 A340s listed as active, with another 35 or so quad jets listed as parked and another 87 or so listed as stored. Given the status of this aircraft type as old and inefficient, it's questionable if the jets listed stored will indeed ever return to service again. While perhaps a handful of stored Lufthansa A340-600s may eventually be reactivated, it's unlikely that the three SAS A340-300s will ever fly out of their current home at the Marana storage site in Arizona. Those listed as parked have a much better chance of flying again, but there is always the possibility that these will eventually have their status changed to stored. Azerbaijan Airlines is one example of an airline that has been on the fence with the fate of its A340s. While it does have a single A340-600 actively flying VIP government services at the moment, the carrier was set to end A340-500 operations in mid-2021. However, it brought these back later in the year. While the pair of aircraft are parked at the moment, with no passenger services scheduled for the remainder of 2022, there's always the possibility that Azerbaijan Airlines brings one or both of the aircraft back as unplanned substitutions. We mention all of this to make it clear that there could be more A340s flying in the future, but it's an unlikely prospect, at least for the majority of owners who have decided to park or store their quad jets. So which airlines are you most likely to secure a flight on an Airbus A340 these days? Well, unfortunately, it's not a very long list. In terms of passenger airlines, we have the following operators. German carrier Lufthansa has the largest active fleet of A340s with 19. These break down to 15-300s and 4-600s. Another 8 quad jets are parked and are also a mix of -300s and -600s. In early March, the airline welcomed -600 back to active operations. The plan is for a total of 5-600s to gradually return to service, providing additional capacity for the airline over the coming months. Sent to storage at the start of the pandemic, the -600s were brought back to service to offer more first-class seats, a cabin which is absent in some of its other long-haul fleet. As we mentioned in our Lufthansa fleet video, this temporary move will come to an end when the airline takes delivery of A350-900s equipped with a first-class cabin. The first of these is due to be delivered in July 2023. Lufthansa plans to operate a one-in, one-out policy, meaning that each time an Airbus A350-900 with first class arrives, an A340-600 will be retired. Commenting on the reactivation in late 2021, an airline spokesperson said that 5-600s would be reactivated for the summer flight schedule for Munich. Meanwhile, fellow Lufthansa Group carrier Swiss International Airlines, better known as just Swiss, has 5 active A340-300s. At the same time, another Lufthansa Group member, leisure-focused carrier Edelweiss Air, is actively operating 4 A340-300s. Spanish long-haul airline Plus Ultra has 2-300s and 1-600. Out of their hub in Madrid, The Dash 300s fly fairly regularly to Lima and Caracas, while the Dash 600 had been mostly operating between Madrid and Chengdu in recent months. Outside of Europe, Iran seems to be the second best place to get a ride on the A340. The country's Mahan Air is listed as having 7 active A340s, a mix of Dash 300s and Dash 600s. Another Iranian airline, Iran Asaman Airlines, has a single A340-300 in service, flying regularly between Tehran and Istanbul. Next door, in Afghanistan, Cam Air operates 3 A340-300s. These fly regular services out of Kabul to cities like Dubai in the UAE and Jeddah in Saudi Arabia. Meanwhile, Syrian Air's 1 active A340-300, registered Yankee Kilo Alpha Zulu Alpha, operates routine service from Damascus to Dubai, Abu Dhabi, Sharjah, and Cairo. Over in South America, Venezuela's Convianza apparently has 4 active A340s, 1-200, 1-300, and 2-600s. Bucking the trend of A340 retirements, Convianza received its A340-600 in late March. Registered Yankee Victor 3533, this jet is the first of 3 it'll get in 2022. Indeed, the airline will take delivery of another Airbus A340-600 and an A340-500 in the next months. And finally, in Africa, we have 2 operators. First, there's Nigeria's Azman Air, which has a single ex-Virgin Atlantic A340-600, registered 5 November Alpha Alpha Mike. This operates between the Nigerian city of Kano to Jeddah and is fitted with an incredibly unique and possibly awkward pair of business class seats situated in front of 411 economy seats. Down south, South African Airways has a single Dash 300, which it flies regularly between Johannesburg and Lagos. The aircraft, registered as Zulu Sierra Sierra X-ray Foxtrot, occasionally flies out of Cape Town as well and periodically serves the Ghanaian capital of Accra. The remaining active A340s mostly fall into 2 categories, VIP government transports or wet lease services. When it comes to governments using the A340 as presidential or VIP transport, we have the previously mentioned Azerbaijan, but also several governments in the Middle East. These include Qatar, Egypt, Libya, Saudi Arabia, Iran, Kuwait, and Turkey. In North Africa, the government of Algeria has an A340-500, while the Kingdom of Eswatini has a single Dash 300. The Royal Thai Air Force has an active Dash 500, while the German Air Force also operates a pair of A340-300s. The government of Egypt might be one operator that could soon retire its single A340-200. That's because it has acquired a Lufthansa-ordered Boeing 747-8i, which is now registered Sierra Uniform Echo Golf Yankee. The aircraft had previously been sitting in storage in the Californian desert until it found its new owner. At present, the double-decker is in Hamburg, likely at Lufthansa Technik, getting its new VIP interior installed. Lufthansa Technik highlights that its services offer more than just creating a beautiful cabin. The firm states the following about its VIP cabin services. "We are able to conceptualize interiors for all international styles, always employing the finest luxury components and materials. From clean government style to rich Baroque or cool Asian, our team of designers and engineers is ready to show endless possibilities." Well, it certainly sounds like a big step up from a 28-year-old A340-200, even if the never-used 747-8 is now over 11 years of age. And for leases, there's one notable arrangement this summer. Air Senegal will be increasing its services from Dakar to Paris on certain weeks between June and September. The airline has been wet leasing Niner Hotel Zulu Mike Kilo, a 17-year-old A340-300, which comes from Malta's Air Hub Aviation. It will eventually change this to a different A340-300, one operated by Highfly Malta, registered Niner Hotel Sierra Zulu November. From the looks of it, the Airbus A340 may be out of production, but it's far from extinction. However, unless you're a head of state or other government VIP, there aren't too many places you'll be able to step on board one of these aircraft. Depending on your nationality, those from the Western world will find their best chances with Lufthansa, Swiss, or Edelweiss. On the other hand, those in the Middle East certainly have a few options, with quite a few airlines as well. It's quite interesting to observe that there are more A340 operators out there than those flying Airbus's other quad jet, the A380. Indeed, if sanctions against certain countries persist, perhaps it's possible that the A340 will outlive the A380 in terms of active commercial service. The A380, after all, is much more costly to operate and isn't able to access as many airports as its older but smaller sibling. We'll just have to wait 20 more years to see how the numbers change. Have you ever flown on an Airbus A340? And do you think there's any possibility that it could outlast the A380? Share your experiences and opinions by leaving a comment. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.